karma goes waste. Its effect is very clear. If you do wrong action, you are going to face the wrong consequences. Good action, good, that we said last time. It was clear. And then collection of the karma. Now this collected karma, karma sanskar, karma, they are responsible for three things. So in next birth when you are born, the first thing with which you are born is jati, the type of person we are. First of all, are we into any species, ant, mosquito and that type, or we go further, any animal type or human, male, female, all this jati is fixed because of our karmas which we have done in past. Now understand this jati. We are born as a human. The other things though, things are not in their hand. They would be born, they would be dying, again they get birth, again they get death. So birth and death phenomenon continues. But in humans, we are born with a particular trait. Jati is a particular trait, the type of person. Now the type of person means here is some person who gets angry very easily. Here is a person who worries a lot. Here is a person who reacts very fast. Here is a person who is always sad and negative. Nothing, he doesn't see anything good in the world. And his negative personality, quite a lot about it. And so on so forth. You will find that in humans, all these varieties of type of people are seen. Right from childhood, you will notice, here is a child who doesn't talk much, or here is a child who is very happy-go-lucky type, or here is a child who sits and worries a lot, or he has lots of fear, what will happen type. So these are the personalities right from the beginning which you can point it out. Now, since we are born with this trait, we cannot change that. That is going to remain with us for the whole life. It's clear. But under the influence of this jati, if we do our action, then it would be wrong because we are going to be bound by our action. Maybe I give example and you understand that suppose here is a person who gets angry very fast. Now under, he gets angry because that's his nature. That's how he is born. Others may not get angry in the same situation, but he gets. Now under the influence of anger, if he is doing any action, what would he do? He'll shout, he'll break the things, will insult somebody, and so on and so forth. Now every action what he does, he will have to face the consequences of the action, because these actions he has done under the influence of kleshas. These are the kleshas. Now that means that because I have this nature, I will be doing all wrong actions only in my life, and again die, and again be born, and again die. What is this going on? So the message is clear that, well, you do get angry, accept it, because that's what you are born with. But be alert, become aware that under this influence of anger, you will not do any action. Action would be wrong. So if I find I am getting angry, I should keep my mouth shut. I should talk very softly, or I should not talk. I should go away from that place which is causing anger. I should be meditating a bit to see that I have a little bit more mastery over my speech, my action. Now, I will still get angry, but I will not do my actions. And slowly, slowly, anger also will not come. But if I work on myself, but still, in some cases, I may still get angry, which others may not, because I am born with that trait. So I should know this is what I am. I must understand who am I, what is my nature, and how do I behave. I must correct that and see that I don't behave under the influence of kleshas. So this is the guidance given, and we should become very, very alert about what action we are doing. It can be done or no. If you are alert, if you know now I am getting angry, let me do something. Rather than getting angry and anger totally overpowering me and then doing wrong action, shouting or behaving rudely or any of these things. So be careful about it. There are many who tell me, Hansaji, the child doesn't listen to me, so I really get disturbed. Once I tolerate, next time again I tolerate, but third time I can't tolerate. Then I have to give a spank. Now this is how people talk to me. Now if you know that here is a child who wants to run away here and there and you want that child to sit and study, now it's a big challenge. First of all, and you are a personality who gets angry also very easily, you will end up pushing your child or spanking your child or shouting at your child. You will ultimately do that only because you are going to get angry. Child is not your bonded labor that you tell child, sit, he will sit, or study, child will study. Not possible. Now you should know that now if the anger is coming up, once you said child didn't hear, second time you child didn't hear, now you better do something else. And maybe play with child for some time, do something, find out how to go about, but not get angry. So well, I'm just giving few examples which I see in families. And you should know that just because of your personality type, which you usually get angry, you are supposed to be careful about your actions.